decisions to buy. From a social value perspective, that's very in line with how Facebook operates as a company. We've been around now for 13 years, and we're starting to understand, we're still a teenager, as I like to say, we're starting to understand the role that we play in delivering social value around the world. So you may have heard us do things like safety check when disasters strike and people can find their friends. We do Amber Alerts now in over 9 countries where children can be found and the notice can be in their news feed. And we do a lot of work around pets. This is actually an example through Petfinder of a shelter near our headquarters, Family Dog Rescue, that was started by a woman who actually was suffering from cancer. She decided as she went through her treatment that really her love was about pets, and particularly around pets that actually were ill and needed medical attention, which was often very, very expensive. And so Angela, as she worked through her breast cancer treatment, launched Family Dog Rescue. Launched Family Dog Rescue, and when they put it together, she actually was able to raise $60,000 via Facebook ads. And we are seeing dog rescue, cat rescue, and animal rescue in general all around the world utilizing Facebook to drive attention and awareness in a very, very big way. As a matter of fact, I am very close to, we're having a little bit of an issue, I apologize. From Petfinder, from my perspective, is very near and dear to my heart because it is actually where I found one of my dogs cancer. So we share the social value of giving back and making sure that animals and pets have a very important place on Facebook. Okay, so what can we do as a company to help you achieve your vision of personalization at scale in order to drive significant business growth? The way I would think about it is in these 3 categories. Number 1, the importance, and I can't stress this enough, of being a mobile-first, consumer-centric marketing organization. The 2nd is, as amazing as the data can be, you've heard it all morning, and we agree, at the end of the day, you still need millions of people buying your products. And the 3rd is that every dollar you invest on our platforms, and we would tell you on any platform, should be measurable and delivering a real business result. Sometimes that business result, as Tom today likes to remind us, may be a learning agenda, but often it's making sure that we're actually delivering real value for your business. Now, on the mobile first story, you probably have heard this over and over again, but sometimes even at Facebook, when we're a mobile company now, we have to remind ourselves that this is the most profound shift we have ever seen in our lifetime. So this is the 3 hours per day, which is happening. And I know Sasha said something a little bit earlier that sometimes we know this is happening as humans, and then we show up as marketers at 9 o'clock, 8 o'clock in the morning, whenever you get into the office, and we sometimes forget what actually people are doing with their lives. And they're spending an enormous amount of time on mobile. They're checking their phones 30 times a day. Millennials are checking their phones 150 times a day. It's become instinctual, like blinking an eye. And ironically, we have found that people are even less distracted on mobile than they are TV. This does not mean that mobile replaces TV, but can be an incredible complement. This is a little bit of a tough chart to see, so I'll just point out what we should look at. This is Facebook usage during the Walking Dead finale. So this is, as people are watching TV, are they actually on Facebook? And what you find, those big peaks, those big blue mountains, if you will, are people's usage during commercial breaks. They are sitting and watching TV, but they've got their device in their hand. The only time you see spikes in consumer behavior during an actual show is when something so monumental happens that people can't do anything but other than, I've got to comment on it now. Did you just see what happened? We've done this for the Olympics, we've done this for primetime shows, and what it basically is showing is there is at least 2 devices out, the television and the mobile screen, and people are going back and forth between them. And so the traditional ways, at least, to think about reaching our consumers have to evolve based on this consumer behavior. And we're living in a world where everything is competing with everything. The average consumer in the U.S. sees well over 700 ad messages a day. So how do you stand out? You stand out by moving towards a world where disruption used to get us what we needed. We would get that message in front of people to actually one of connection. How do you create meaningful customer experiences where people actually want to react to you? And the environment is changing dramatically. So this is The Late Show with James Corden on CBS. Super funny show. About a million people watch it at night. Well, even folks like James Corden has said, okay, how do I take that content, bring it into a mobile environment? And obviously, you've seen Carpool Karaoke. It's a great opportunity to get a little bit of James Corden. And over 100 million people get to see this content. It's 100x what he's able to do in a traditional world. Or take Tim Cook when he launches Apple products. People used to like die to get into that room to say, I want to be part of that experience. And his 82-minute show, well now Apple's taken that 82-minute show, put it to 107 seconds, and 52 million people are able to experience it versus thousands. This is happening with fashion shows, a complete revolution in the democratization of getting people information. Here's an example from the food category, which is totally being reinvented. So the Rachel Ray Show typically gets about 1.2 million people watching it. This is through BuzzFeed, the Tasty brand. They take a recipe show that would typically be 45 minutes, they condense it to 45 seconds, 11 million people are able to see it. This is an awesome time to be a marketer because you can get your message, if it is relevant and delightful, in the hands of so many more people than you were ever able to before. Google is working really closely with us to reinvent how people find out about search. So they've taken a message that typically would have taken 30 seconds, condensed it into less than 5 seconds to give people a reminder, a product demo on how to quickly use Google search and get value out where to find an ice cream. Last night I was talking to some of your colleagues about the trend in performance marketing. What are marketers like The Honest Company doing, Ipsy, or Michael Kors, in terms of reinventing the way they go to market? So the first example over here is Jessica Alba from The Honest Company, who launched her entire new diaper line on Facebook Live. She was able to interact with consumers, get immediate feedback, and have that be available on her site. Or Ipsy. Ipsy has now moved 95% of their spend into video because it is driving performance at a level they had never seen before. Ipsy was a traditional direct marketer, $10 subscription, and they've moved it completely into video. This last one is Michael Kors, and this is a shoppable feed. You saw earlier the opportunity to actually talk to Alexa and order new products and have that be all automated. This is something that's launching on Facebook in the next month. It is going to allow marketers to not only show video of their products, but then immediately get people to actually purchase them directly from the feed into that marketer's website. And so I share these examples just to show you the breadth and how fast this is moving. Live didn't exist a year ago. Shoppable video hasn't even launched, it'll launch next month. And a year ago, performance marketers were barely using our video product. It's moving really, really quickly. The next three examples, slides that I'm gonna share with you are really three different types of consumer behavior for you to think about. As you think about creating content, and I know you've got two fantastic internal teams working on that, which I think is a real competitive advantage for you. One is on the go. And I think you can become really good at this. These are snackable bites of consumer content in less than 3 seconds. Could be a cinemagraph, a moving picture. It could be a short form video like from Ralph Lauren. It could be Mountain Dew trying to pull you in what we call create thumb stopping content. This is on the go. You're walking, you're waiting for a bus, you're waiting for a meeting to start, you're waiting for to move to your next classroom. The second type of behavior to think about is lean forward consumption. This is when something is appearing in the feed environment and you decide, you know what, I want to spend a little bit more time with that. We launched Instagram Stories just a few months ago. There are now over 150 million people and marketers and brands using Instagram Stories, which was more than all of Snapchat. Now, that just happened in the last few months. That doesn't mean that Snapchat's not growing, it is, but it is how fast with product innovation you can change the way consumers are interacting with your video. We have a 360 video example here, and we have Canvas. And I show you all of these because while the core capability and the core functionality is 3 seconds or less typically, there are opportunities to engage your consumers in much, much deeper content. Where we think this is going is more even lean back consumption. When consumers decide that their mode of choice in terms of consuming media is going to be lean back on their device, they're going to spend a lot more time on in-depth video. And you're going to see a lot more long-form options coming from Facebook. As I think about where this is going with the scale and the formats and the personalization, last night I was driving to dinner on Highway 40 just around here, and there was this big Toyota billboard. And I thought to myself, it's really interesting.